for the first time in its history, Basin Electric will be buying solar generation on a large scale to serve its membership. Directors authorized the purchase of up to 300 megawatts of solar. Director of Long-Term Utility Planning Becky Kern says proposals for solar generation have been coming to Basin Electric for several years now. Prices are more competitive now than ever before due to production tax credit incentives expiring at the end of this year.
Right now, the solar is very competitive against the market, especially when you look at on-peak market, and you know, since that's where the generation will be producing is during those, you know, daytime hours. You know, when you factor in the amount of capacity that you're going to get, it is actually a fairly competitive project. The solar projects are right now. In the past, they were significantly higher and it just couldn't compete previously. We will have 1600 megawatts of wind within our portfolio and more to come online here over the next couple of years. Solar here just provides a different shape. You know, wind, you know, especially when you've got wind moving through the service territory, it, you know, over time it moves through and you've got those weather patterns that, you know, it kind of comes up and maybe it's delayed in different areas here. It's going to come up when the sun comes up in the morning and it's going to stay up to the extent there's, unless there's cloud cover and stuff like that. So you can have moments, you know, where it's not, but there's, you know, we're looking at diversifying the locations right off the bat, you know, by going with two projects, you know, so you're not putting it all in one location, you know, so you may still have solar generation operating in one location and the other one goes down because of cloud cover and stuff like that. And I think it's just a nice different fuel type to help diversify the portfolio. The value of the capacity that it'll bring, since it will provide generation during the on-peak, typically when our system is peaking, you know, if it's very hot outside, the sun is typically shining, you know, that it's going to provide some capacity value. So that has a lot of value for us.
Kern says these projects will be located within the Southwest Power Pool footprint. There are no utility scale projects currently operating in SPP. She says technology has improved quite a bit in the last couple of years.
There's different technologies that you can go with solar. You can have a fixed asset where it just sits in one place. A lot of the developers that we've been working with, as we've been evaluating things, is looking more at a single axis tracker where it'll track the sun in an east or west direction as the sun comes up in the morning and sets in the evening. There is also one step further with the dual axis tracker. At this point, the economics, you know, for the added cost don't seem to pay for that added value in the market as other alternatives right now.
If you're wondering how much space solar generation requires, Kern says it's a good rule of thumb that every 1 megawatt requires about 7 acres of land. The projects are expected to be commercial by the end of 2022.